Hello and welcome to this AWS Media and Entertainment video tutorial. In this episode, I'm going to spend the next 8 minutes or so talking about Trickplay, which is essentially the term most commonly used for the preview images you sometimes see at the bottom of a video player. I'm Christopher Whitehorn, and I'm a solutions architect at AWS, specializing in our suite of media services. I personally think Trickplay is a great example of a feature available to streaming services that really adds to the user experience in quite a subtle way. It feels quite natural to scroll through the player timeline and see a small thumbnail preview pop up as you move through the video. This capability has been around for a long time. Apple introduced support for iframe-only tags in HLS version 4 back in 2011. But as is often the case in video streaming, there is more than one way to achieve it. HLS allows you to decorate one or more playlist manifests with iframe only. The nice thing about this is that it doesn't require additional media files. It's simply a reference to iframes in one or more existing video renditions. An iframe, in case you don't know, is an independently decodable frame of video, as opposed to BMP frames, which require information from adjacent video frames to be able to decode them. Some devices, particularly those that are resource constrained, can struggle with the additional decoding that's required here. Dash contains support for image playlist files. These can be individual JPEG images, often used in live, or, as shown here, tiles containing multiple thumbnail images, commonly used in video demand applications to reduce the number of object requests. The image track is described within an adaption set. You can see an example here. Segment template with number is used to describe the tiles and their timing. Roku, in conjunction with Warner Media and Disney, led the way in defining a method to add similar image playlist capability to HLS as an extension to the Pantos specification. The HLS Master Manifest looks similar to this. You can see there is a track defined under the EXTX image stream inf tag. Here is an example of the playlist manifest itself. There is a tag stating it contains images. You can also see EXTX tile tags defining each of the JPEG files, their resolution and layout, etc. Roku have also put some constraints on how the tiles should be laid out. Each image should be 312 pixels by 176 pixels and arranged 3 wide by 3 high. Let's take a look at Trickplay in action by creating a video on demand file using Media Convert. So here we are in the Media Convert console. I've already prepared a couple of things. I've defined an input plus my IAM role. Let's take a look at outputs. I'm going to add a dash output. As you can see, there's an image-based Trickplay option. And there's 3 to choose from. The thumbnails, which are the 3x3 format I've described before, that plus a full frame image file. And then we have our advanced settings. These allow us to define the thumbnail width and the thumbnail height. I'm just going to define a width. I'm going to leave the height blank, and Media Convert will choose that in order to maintain aspect ratio. And we can select our tile width and our tile height. So I'm going to choose 4 wide by 4 high. And the last configuration is the interval. You can choose to follow the iframe or a custom interval of your own. I'm going to choose 2 seconds. Let's take a look at HLS outputs as well. You can see there's the same settings available for HLS and CMAF. Exactly the same, it's all the same. Let's just delete those. I'm also going to remove my mixed audio. We don't need that in the dash stream. I also want to create an ABR stack, and for that I'm going to use the automated ABR feature, as I don't have a predefined ladder I need to stick to. I just need to define my output destination. Okay, good. Let's come back once that's completed. Now the job's complete, let's take a look at the output. I'm going to use the dash reference player. Drop in my playback URL. But before we do that, I'm going to open DevTools so we can see what's happening. Let's take a look at the manifest. We can see the adaption set with the image track. And let's look at the JPEG images themselves. So I don't see anything yet, so let's start previewing across the timeline. You can see we're loading the thumbnail images and examining the files themselves. You can see they're tiled 4x4 as I defined it in the configuration. I hope you found this session useful. I've included QR codes linking through to the image media playlist specification, as well as some useful information across various services supporting Trickplay. Thank you for joining. Keep an eye out for new episodes, and I hope to see you at the next video tutorial.